Did I mention that like the optical quality is just incredible? All right, now this is a lot of glass. We're gonna talk today about the differences in our tripod-specific binoculars within our lineup, the Razer UHD 18x56, the Kaibab HD 18x56, and the Diamondback HD 15x56. Now, as usual, when it comes to binoculars, it's a little bit more difficult than rifle scopes to explain because really it boils down to the optics. And on this video, I'm not gonna be able to do a great job of showing you the actual optical differences between these binoculars. That you'll kind of have to see for yourself. So we do always recommend trying to find a local retailer or maybe a buddy that has some of these options if you're trying to compare to actually see for yourself with your own eyes. But that said, there are a couple of feature differences and a few things that I can point out to hopefully help make your decision a little bit easier. We'll start over here with the Diamondback HD 15x56. Now, first off, those other two binoculars that I mentioned are 18 power. So the Diamondback only comes up to 15 power. If you need something with the highest magnification possible within our line in a binocular that goes on a tripod, then that might already push you up into the Kaibab or the Razer UHD. Otherwise, if you're looking for something where 15 power is enough and you want a binocular that's reasonably affordable but still high performance enough to get done what you need it to get done and see things pretty dang far away, the Diamondback HD is a great choice. That line in general, Diamondback HD, for us has long been a workhorse and able to get done most of the same things that you can get done with higher end binoculars, but again, at a more reasonable price. The Kaibab HD here, like we said, is an 18 power binocular, a little bit higher end optical system. If you're familiar with our lineup, we have our Viper HDs and our Razer HDs. This kind of falls in terms of optical quality between those two. Features wise, it's mostly the same, just being a more simple binocular. It does have a locking diopter though, which is a nice thing to have, so you don't have to worry about your particular diopter setting for your eye getting bumped off when you're in the field. Moving up to the Razer UHD 18x56, being in that Razer UHD line, this is the absolute best we have to offer with an alpha class binocular with Abiconic prisms and exceptional optical quality. Now, a few of the features worth mentioning on the Razer UHD here, it has a locking diopter like the Kaibab HD had, and it has a magnesium chassis as well. Now, a magnesium chassis means that we can have it be super strong while also maintaining a reasonably light weight. And again, when it comes to the Razer UHD, it is worth mentioning, this optical system is the best in our lineup and it is exceptional to look through. So certainly one worth giving a shot in your local retailer or if a buddy has one, if you're interested. Now, like we said, all of these are what we would consider tripod-specific binoculars. That is to say, we wouldn't recommend trying to use them handheld. Some people do, and it works for them, but it probably wouldn't work for most people out there. There are other binoculars that can be tripod adapted. In fact, most of our binocular line can be adapted to a tripod, and that doesn't mean that you shouldn't do it. Many times, people use 8s, 10s on tripods, and they do it just fine. The other options you don't see here are some of our 12x50s, which increase the number of binoculars and some of the families that you would get into if you went with a 12, which we consider right on that cusp of being handheld or tripod mounted. So there you have Crossfire HDs, Diamondback HDs, Viper HDs, Razer HDs, and a Razer UHD as well. So lots more options if you're in that more in-between side of things. So that's the breakdown though on our specific high magnification binoculars for tripod glassing. If you have any questions about these models in particular, other binocular models, or just how-tos on tripod glassing, definitely let us know in the comments below, on the phone, email, social media, whatever works. We love talking to you guys. But until the next video, we will see you next time. Thanks as always for watching. Now, a few more features to mention on the Razer UHD here. It has a locking diopter like the Kaibab HD. That I can't unlock. There we go. It's so strong. Okay, that was embarrassing.